Hey guys, it's the computer guy here with another video. Today is a unique day because instead of doing a Minecraft video, we will be doing a Python tutorial. And today I'm going to show you how to make ransomware in Python. Let's get to it. So, you can download this on my GitHub in the link in the description below. And you will see all my code there, so anyways, here is my ransomware that I created, and this function right here is going to copy this file that I just opened 3 times, and then it's going to turn this text file to dot text into virus dot bullet, and then this OS remove function tells us which files to remove. So it's gonna remove the zip file right here, and it's gonna remove these 2 test files, and then you have to enter a password. Please enter the decryption key to decrypt your files. And I just said the password is Apple. And here is FPWD. That means password input. And then print checking password, print successful. And then import os.remove virus.bullet, F open. And then it's going to bring all these files back. Even this zip file here. And then it's going to remove all these files that will appear before you enter the password. Then it's going to remove paytherance.html. So after it else print incorrect decryption key. Are you sure you paid the ransom? Print. To see if your ransom has been paid, look at this website. Wait for 5 seconds. Is time dot? I mean, tens. I'm gonna fix that. Sorry. 10 seconds. Is you have to put time dot sleep, and in parentheses 10. So now we need to write the HTML when the web browser is gonna open and what it's gonna look like. So here, I made a file. The W means write practically, but you don't have to worry about that function today. And paytheransom.html will appear right here, if you know what I'm talking about. This step will go down, and you can see /paytheransom.html. You can't put anything else here, unless you want to rename the whole file, which you have to rename it right here. And write here. Otherwise, let's look at the HTML part. This is the body style is background color. That's going to be powder blue. I'm going to change it to orange. Why? Because I like orange. And then it says H1. Oops. This is the heading. It says, oops, your important files are encrypted. And then this is to set the date we're counting down to. And then all this other stuff, if you know JavaScript, you can definitely read. But this is like the days, the hours, the minutes, and the seconds. And it says another heading here. Pay the ransom to decrypt your files. And then it's a form action. https://udd-he3hedha6aenda. And then this is what the button would look like, and it would say the text would display, click here to pay the ransom. And then it would write the message, which is all the way up here. That's the variable up here. And that's it. So, guess what? We're going to run it and see what it does. Last time it shut my computer down, so then I actually realized how dangerous it was. I almost thought I was going to have a kernel panic. So let's run this module here. As it please enter the your important file is encrypted. Please enter the decryption key to decrypt your files. As you can see, it made copies of this and then put virus.bullet to replace those other files. And if I enter the wrong encryption key, let's say I just enter a bunch of random enter incorrect decryption key. Are you sure you paid the ransom? To see if your ransom has been paid, look at this website. And all we need to do is close this. Why? Because we don't need it anymore. And then it gives us a timer. And if you don't pay the ransom, then your files will be encrypted forever. So that's practically what my ransomware does. Thank you for watching this video. And remember to like and subscribe. That's weird. Like and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time. The Computer Guy is out.